What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. And first off, I told you, y'all guys give me the motivation to make more turbo content and I would bring it to you. Today is no exception. We're going to dive deep into some little bitty Garretts today. We're going to talk about the Garrett GTX Gen 1, Gen 2, also the Garrett G Series and G Series 2. And just maybe if we have a little bit of time, I might even dive into that new GX race unit. Well, enough rambling. Let's get to the turbos. All right, guys, before I jump into all of this, I want to break out this old artifact of a catalogue right here and show y'all a little bit of history. So this is a Garrett Ballistic Concepts catalogue from 1997-1998. I think this one is phase two, so this is 1998. This is just a cool little piece of history of where the Garrett ball bearing turbo program for the aftermarket started. And this goes over everything like their performance products, why they're doing what they're doing with ball bearing, and what they're going to do as far as phase one, phase two, and how to bring this into the performance aftermarket. I thought this was really cool, but it starts off with, you know, their performance catalog before there were really a performance catalog for these turbos. So a lot of it is OE parts that are brought over into the ball bearing structure, but a little piece of history nonetheless. Ballistic Concepts. So, and if any of y'all guys are in the know and you know if it was called something before Ballistic Concepts, definitely chime in and hit me up and let me know. All right, let's get to the all this. This mess of stuff I have on my table right here is exciting. So let me get you set up and we'll start talking about them. All right, so my workbench is very busy. I do apologize for it, but it's busy with a lot of really cool things. So this was a prime time for me to talk about the differences between some of the generations of the Garrett ball bearing turbo. I'm going to start off with the small guy. I've got a GTX. This is your first generation GTX. This will be a 2860. Okay, so GT28 turbine wheel, which is your 10 blade turbine, the familiar ball bearing center cartridge that carries over from GT25 all the way to GT35, and Garrett's first machined compressor wheel for the performance aftermarket anyway, and the ball bearing cartridge. For a little bit of comparison, this is your GT2860 cast wheel, and it's a six blade, six splitter, so six primary blades, six splitter blades, and this would have been the factory compressor wheel on like your Nissan SR. This would have been, I guess, S15 or late S14. Y'all guys can correct me on that. I'm still getting a little bit of my history on the SR series stuff, but GTX, 11 primary blades, 11 plus O. The plus O means no splitter, where this is a 6 plus 6, so a splitter style wheel. So we picked up a little bit of different aero and obviously brought Garrett into the limelight with their GTX series compressors. This is what started it all for them in the little small ball bearing turbo getting some notoriety. So pretty cool. GT series turbine, which was the same as the cast wheel turbos, but it just evolved into the GTX compressor wheel. So next thing I want to say, because there's a lot sitting here to talk about, let's see what I can find. Oh, Gen 2. So this is what we call a Gen 1 or a 11 blade GTX wheel. Set this guy down and we'll grab a Gen 2. All right, so Gen 2. What changed? Still the same familiar bearing housing. This is a GT30, so it's a little bit larger turbine wheel, but still shares the same 10 blade aero. And Garrett basically, even through today, once they grab an aero program that they like, and they're going to just change the sizes of it. So inducer, exducer will change, but the blade design architecture pretty much remains the same. There are obvious exceptions to that, but that's the general rule of thumb, especially in the smaller scale turbos. So GT30, still GT Aero, but this is a Gen 2. So Gen 2 compressor wheel gets a 10 blade instead of 11. And if we look at the blade architecture, you can see the blades have a much more aggressive laid back profile to them. Garrett's chasing efficiency, and as engines get more and more efficient, they also get smaller. So sometimes you got to step the boost pressure way up to get them things to make horsepower. So having a compressor wheel that's a little more efficient at a higher boost pressure was their goal, and also getting higher volume out of a given size. So GT30, this is a 3076 Gen 2, and I'll pull the Gen 1 wheel out and show you the profile of it as well. But like I said, the blade layover is really aggressive on this, but a really really well-developed compressor wheel for its intended use. Let's show you the Gen 1 again, just for kind of comparison, and get a little bit of idea of the profile differences. But Garrett kept the GT series center section and the GT turbine wheel. There were a couple of turbos that I think the RS series that got a little different turbine wheel trim and maybe some different turbine aero. But for the most part, all of your GTX 28, GTX 30, and even into the GTX 35s, Gen 1 and Gen 2 all shared similar architecture in relationship to size, as far as the aero goes on the turbine wheel. So basically, it's just compressor aero that has been upgraded. Where does that lead us next? See if I can find it. Got a couple to choose from. Here it is. Here's G30. This is actually a G35. So 10 blade compressor wheel still. Still that radical swept-back design. And the wheel, for the most part, is almost the same as Gen 2 Garrett Aero. Actually, I'll do a direct comparison here. I forgot I had this. So here's a, back to our 3076. Here is a G30-660. And as you can see, even though they're two distinctly different horsepower ratings for the size, but if you look at the layover on the blade and just the general attributes of it, they're very, very similar. So Garrett just pushed the development of the Gen 2 into the G series a little bit further and gained a little bit more flow, a little bit more efficiency, but they still have that radical layover, which is definitely plays into how this turbo performs, and we'll dive into that at some point. But right now we're just showing the basic differences between them. All right, so just so we back on track, you can see the traditional T25, T28, T30, T35 style bearing housing with the separate back plate. These would interchange depending on your compressor covers, whether it was going in a small compact cover. You see the snap ring here and this back plate. We'll pull the little guy back up again. You can see that it's essentially the same bearing housing. They just have different adapters to fit different compressor covers, whether it's a TO4B, a GT35 style cover, or what have you. All right, so we go back into G series. So G series, similar compressor wheel architecture, the way the aggressive layover, just, you know, pushing the design a little bit more, but it's an entirely new bearing housing. And it's an integral back plate all cast into one, unfortunately, heavy cast iron hunk right here. But that is done for a specific reason. They wanted to shrink the size of these guys. They wanted to make them as compact as possible. And there was just no way to do it with the older architecture. Plus the removable back plate and stuff, they're not that they're problematic. It just adds more part numbers into the catalog, and Garrett, probably like any manufacturer, wants to streamline component count in a part, because component count is money. So different bearing housing and a radically different turbine wheel. You see, we went from a 10 bladed wheel to now a 9 bladed turbine. The turbine wheel is also quite a bit more radically open and scalloped for lighter weight, and it has a much more aggressive tip height, or the distance from the flat of the blade to where it progresses into the radius. So completely different aero. There's nothing that'll interchange between a GT series and a G series as far as like housings. So they are, a whole clean sheet of paper. Turbo difference for sure. The non-bladed turbine. Definitely one of the coolest things is turbine technology to me. I see a lot of different things out there over the years. And back when we just had to put turbos together out of OE catalog parts, we didn't have the ability to machine a compressor wheel or do whatever. We would always go digging through everything to find the turbine wheel we wanted first and then work on the compressor wheel from there. Let me see if I have a little bit better comparison here for you. I thought I would do this. So here's this is a GT3071 and then the G30-660. What basically 23 years of technology gets you there in Garrett anyway. But you can definitely see the radical layover of the blade design versus the cast wheel. All right, so let's see. What did I want to pull up next? We'll jump around a little bit. Here's a G25-550 turbine wheel. Really, really cool. So still shares the same 9-blade geometry as the G30. As you can see, they just scale it up, like I said. So pretty straightforward in how they go about their architecture changes. Another little side note is the G series has twin piston ring seal rings on the exhaust side and the compressor side too. But definitely a lot of neat little engineering attributes to this wheel. All right, so what's next? Let's see. Oh, the G2 series. Just happened to have a pair of these that we're doing some upgrades to for one of our really good customers. But take a look at that. Still a 10-blade compressor, 10+0. But look what they did. They really, really aggressively changed the blade profile. Tip height is a lot taller. The blades are more vertical. They're going to definitely perform quite a bit different. I am trying hard not to say Garrett kind of started going down a path with this compressor wheel that is really good for certain applications, but unfortunately doesn't perform in a wide range of applications. You notice that, the best thing ever is always the latest and greatest. So you had your G series, which is, the best turbo that Garrett's made. And then all of a sudden you see a G2 pop up and you're like, what in the world? Why are they doing that? Why so quick? Because it takes OEs a long time to release products sometimes, working with Garrett, BorgWarner, whoever, if it's a big OE, producer of parts, getting things changed doesn't happen overnight. But did Garrett see the writing on the wall that maybe they had a really awesome turbine wheel, but needed a more aggressive compressor wheel to match it? Well, only time will tell, that's for sure. Really cool. G2. This one is a G35-900 that we have modified for a specific racing class to get us a 58mm inducer. So, yep, more crazy custom stuff in the shop. All right, let me get you set back up over here in just a second. We'll look at a few other little things. All right, got you set up over here, and I'm gonna bounce back to the Gen 1 GTX, and I do a lot of bouncing around because this kind of shot off the hip right here, but I have a G25 that is headed out to our good friend Chris Rednick, and wanted to just pull up a direct comparison of, so there's your, on the left, there's your GTX Gen 1, and here is, on the right, your G series, the G25-550 wheel. So again, you can see that. And still just a... Here's your technology there. We still do a lot of cast wheel turbos. Believe it or not, they have their place. We're going to get into that in a future video. We're going to talk about compressor maps. We're also going to talk about real world performance versus a compressor map, how to look at all that stuff basically, and what to be concerned about and what to just throw by the wayside and never worry with at all. Let's see. Reach in front of the camera. So this is the Gen 1 GTX, just a TO4B cover. And interesting on this turbo is, this is still, even though I just bought it a couple of days ago, it's a Honeywell product. You know, Honeywell hasn't had a stake in Garrett in a number of years. And the Gen 2 GT3076 we just got, it'll focus right there. Garrett, Japan. All the ballistic concepts and original ball bearing turbos came out of Japan. I guess the reasoning was is most of the Garrett factory there that was building most of the product for Nissan at the time. You know, I mentioned the SR. Nissan also had a six-cylinder diesel engine. That's where the GT35 came from. It was a diesel engine, obviously, with a ball bearing turbo on it. So a lot of the Japanese domestic market got the ball bearing stuff. But back to the TO4, you know, the original ones were just modified existing covers that were readily available. And then the new G series cover, definitely really cool with the boost pressure port, speed sensor port. This one's ported shroud, obviously all of them are, but still very, you know, they kept the size. So they'll interchange pretty closely. Oh, jumping around like I always do. So here is the G2, G35. And if you see, if it'll focus right here, Garrett, and then right up here at the top, you'll see Mexico. You know, obviously it's a global company, and I'm sure all the parts are made in the same factories. They're just where their ultimate destination are assembled is where that tag has to be put on their app. Any of y'all guys work for Garrett? Jump in and chime in and tell me where I'm right or where I'm wrong. Let's see. What was the next thing I wanted to go over with y'all guys? I think this kind of covers the small stuff. All right, set up and back around in front of the camera. And I know I've said this a million times, but thank you very much for watching these videos. And I've got a ton to share. And I keep telling y'all keep liking these things and keep me motivated. I'm going to share as much as I can with you. So I've got lots of great suggestions for video content. And I hope y'all guys know if you've been leaving me comments that I've tried to answer all of your questions and at least give you a thumbs up if something is exciting or whatnot. But thank you. That's really the last thing we'll say in front of this camera before I let y'all guys go and get on with your Friday. But hey, hope y'all have a great weekend. And if there's anything we can do for you, hit us up. Y'all guys take care. Catch you on the next one.